Excuse me, sir. May I ask you a couple questions?
Sure.
My name is Calvin Butler. I'm the director of the RBBS Logistics Learning Center.
Sure.
We manage the National Dispatchers Network, more than 3,000 dispatchers and freight brokers across the country.
Okay.
How long have you been in the trucking industry? 17 years?
15.
15 years, that's a long time. You don't see it at all.
I'm sorry?
You don't see it at all, ain't you?
Oh, you can say that.
All right, look. I drove trucks for about 6 years myself. You know, I started out with Covenant. Then I went out on the road, became my own operator. I started my own brokerage firm, and now I do a dispatch firm, and we do this learning center where we help dispatchers learn how to, you know, find the high dollar freight and try to keep trucks moving in Panama, you know, decent rates. What is the main problem you see right now with the industry?
The main problem? Oh, wow, where you start? You mean on the regulatory side or?
Just whatever.
Okay. Well, on the regulatory side, and I guess you're trying to do something like that just now, is a lot of the regulations come down from the FMCSA, mm-hmm. DC. Don't exactly match up with the reality of what we're actually seeing in the trenches.
Exactly.
That's why a lot of the rules don't work. That's, you know, in fact, I'd say that's why you have ELDs, because people are cheating on their laws.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason they were cheating on their laws, not necessarily because they wanted more profit, whatever. You have to remember, a lot of these guys out here are company drivers.
Mm-hmm.
They're not getting any paid anymore.
Exactly.
What was happening was dispatchers or the needs of the customers were causing these timetables to be heaped upon these drivers, that they had to cut 15 minutes here or 15 minutes there just to make those loads on time.
Yeah.
And in fact, there was a popular refrain of a lot of dispatchers to, if you were a driver, you had a load that there was just no way you could legally make it. You tell the dispatcher, he'd say, fits it in the bucks. Well, ELDs took that away.
Wow.
So what happened, and you're seeing it now, what's happening is ever since everyone had to go to ELDs, a lot of dispatchers and brokers are starting to find out that certain loads that were makeable within a day,
They're not makeable anymore.
They're finding out just how those drivers that were fudging those laws, they're finding out just how much of a favorite
exactly.
they were being
exactly.
done.
And that's hurting everybody in the pocket. But it's causing them to take more risks and cause more dangerous,
dangerous on the highway. You're seeing people out here driving a little faster.
Exactly.
Now because, you know, they're up, they're smack up against this 14-hour clock that doesn't stop no matter what. If I'm going through 610 loop in Houston, and it's rush hour, you know, the average you're doing is about maybe 2 to 5 miles an hour. Oh well, that clock is not going to stop.
Nope.
So you can't just pull. It's not like the old days where you can just pull over to the side and wait out rush hour.
Exactly.
And I'm
maybe even take you a nap or two.
Yeah.
You know, be more refreshed. Be even safer on the road.
Well, I'm starting to see something. We're starting to see something a little more encouraging now. The FMCSA just put out a set of proposed rule changes.
Yeah.
I think it was like maybe the beginning of this
month. Yeah, I read that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I read that. Where they're making, like, for your 30-minute stop or your half-hour stop and things like this, and there, certain things don't go against your clock anymore.
Exactly.
Which, because what they're starting to see is that the very rules that they put in place to increase safety is actually
the exact opposite.
They're causing more accidents. They're causing people to be in a mind frame of rush.
They're speed. Think about bringing back the split sleeper berth.
Exactly. I read that when they were talking about the split sleeper berth and things,
they're
and things
be
of that nature.
With that, though, because so many people got in trouble with that, mm-hmm. because you'd be surprised at how many people don't know how to properly split sleeper berth. And I don't think it's that you have that many stupid people out there. It's just that every time I've seen someone explain it, they haven't explained it correct.
Exactly.
They're not being taught this correct.
Exactly.
And so we're starting to, you know, Washington's starting to get a clue, saying, hey, these guys need some flexibility. You know, they're starting to realize that trucking isn't, number one, it's, how can I say this? I'm not trying to insult everyone at the, you know, at, on Capitol Hill.
I understand.
Okay, but the reason a lot of these regs don't make sense or don't fit is because the people up there who are, the people up there in the agencies who are making the regulations, what they see, you know, they're all white collar people.
Yeah.
They're used to the 9-to-5 type thing.
Exactly.
So they think any job they've ever heard of has been 9-to-5.
Yeah. It makes sense on paper.
Yeah.
But
every job they've ever heard of except for this one. And so they a lot of people up there can't wrap their heads around a job that is literally 24/7, 365. So the rules
in all types of conditions.
Exactly. in conditions, they would be advised to sit home.
Exactly. Mountains, snow, ice.
You got it. and so what's happening is they're starting to, I'm guessing that there's some people up there they're starting to realize, okay, this profession is a completely different alien. It's a completely different ball of wax from what we're used to, what we know. So maybe the regs ought to reflect that reality.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's not just that, but it's also the fact that to the person who's never driven a truck before, they think all trucking is the same.
No, it's not. look, man, I could do a whole show on you just by yourself. What's your name?
Jim.
Jeremy. Look, Jeremy, you on with, you know, with all my students. This is broadcast on YouTube and,
okay.
And on like 15 different other trucking groups on Facebook. You know, we have the largest network of independent dispatchers and freight brokers and owner operators in the country. We're more than 3,700 members strong. We have dispatchers in every country on the planet. Okay, so thank you, man.
Hey,
I appreciate it, man. You know, keep doing what you're doing. You know, I don't know what your aspirations are, what your goals are, but look us up with the RBBS Logistics Learning Center and RBBS Transport. That's my dispatch firm.
All right.
But you go on YouTube and put in, RBBS Logistics Learning Center, put about 150 plus videos of what we have training sessions, we have weekly trainings for all our dispatches and stuff. So yeah, we appreciate you, man.
Hey, you got it.
Really appreciate you, all right?
Appreciate you stopping by.
No problem, anytime. And keep doing what you're doing, man.
Thanks.
All right. All right, everybody. We're going to try and wrap. How you doing, sir? All right, we're going to try and wrap this up because my battery's about to go dead. But I want y'all to know that I appreciate y'all for joining us. I really do. I appreciate all the things that you all bring to the table. I appreciate all the kind words, and I appreciate you. All the support that you all bring to our platform and to our network, and we're gonna keep striving to bring bigger and better things to you all, so that we can show more love, and we're gonna do it. We try and show love in the manner that where it really matters helps you all to earn great living and be able to provide for your families and be able to provide for the truckers and stuff out there so that they can make more money, because that's what it's all about. But we appreciate all of that. And this has been Calvin, and today's training has been field training live from the Flying J here in Midway, Florida. So we've been live here at the Midway, at the Flying J Travel Plaza here in Midway, Florida. And I appreciate y'all for joining us. As you can see here, we got all the people out here, great people out here at the Flying J, and this is what it's all about. Thank y'all again. Don't forget, tomorrow at 9 a.m. on our conference call channel, okay? Go to our conference call channel. Look us up on Facebook. It will be the Logistics Entrepreneur Symposium, okay? You can go to our page, RBBS Transport, or the RBBS Logistics Learning Center. Look that up. We have the Logistics Entrepreneurs Symposium. And we're going to be showing you all how y'all can take part in what we have that's coming up in the guaranteed career placement events that we're going to be having throughout the country in four cities in every state. Thank y'all again. We appreciate each and every one of them, even every last one of you all. This has been Calvin with the Six Figures Booking Freight from Home Show. Y'all have a good one. Bye now.